Hello friends, how are you today? I hope all of you are doing well. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the recruit open position at Bharat Electronics Limited, also commonly known to us as BEL Bell. Okay, now BEL Bell or Bharat Electronics Limited is a Government of India organization and comes under the Ministry of Defence. So as you can see here, this is a circular issued by the company themselves on their website. Okay, and this is like they have a software division. Okay, and based in Bangalore. All right, so they engagement of trainee engineers and project engineers. So this circular explains about two open positions. Okay, this was issued on 7th, and the two open positions are trainee engineers and project engineers. So here if you see the something about the company is written as to what Bell is. So for those who have heard about Bell for the first time, this is some information for your knowledge. So scrolling further, so this is about the position that has been given. So if you see here, so this is the first position that they have been talking about. So this is trainee engineer. So the post code for this is SDTE. Guys, make sure you remember this post code because this is what is going to help you while filling the registration form. All right. So qualification. So again, if you look at the qualification, they have asked for a full-time engineer, BE or BTech, with first class. Okay, this is for general categories. OBC EWS stands for economically weaker section candidates, and pass class for SC ST and for people with disability. So PW stands for people with disability. So this is an opening for full-time BE BTech computer science graduate. Okay, and if he's a general candidate, it is first class. OBC EWS candidate and past for general OBC and EWS candidates, it is first class, and past class for SC ST and people with disability. Okay, so there are 54 open positions at Bangalore, and this is the remuneration structure that has been given. So for the first year, for the second year, for the third year. Okay, so again, this is the seat distribution. So all 54 is not open for everybody. So this UR stands for unreserved. There are 21 unreserved seats. EWS stands for economically weaker sections, 4 seats for them. OBC stands for other backward classes. Okay, so 15 seats for them. Scheduled caste, 8 seats. Scheduled tribes, 5 seats. And people with disability, there is 1 seat reserved for them. Okay, now minimum post qualification experience. So how do you know this is for a fresher? So this is the experience that is required. So here it is said not applicable nil. That means this is for a fresher. Okay. Post qualification. That means post you are qualified as a BE BTech. Your experience should be nil. Okay. So this is what is asked. Job requirement. So you should have knowledge on Java, J2EE, C++. Knowledge in software development using C++. So this is what has been asked. Okay. Similarly, for the second requirement also, if you see, there has been similar kind of fields have been filled. So they are asking for engineers only. These are the compensations, these are the seat distributions, and this is the minimum experience that is required. And these are the knowledge that the candidate needs to be. However, this is not of none of our concern because we are focusing on the fresher requirement. So going down, yeah. So this is the eligibility criteria. So first is nationality. The candidate who is applying must be a citizen of India. Second is age as on this date. Okay. So 1st November 2020 is the cutoff date. So on first September 2020 is the cutoff date. So on 1st September, what is your age? Okay, that will be considered. So if your age, so for this position that we are applying for, if your age is about 25 years, your application will not be considered. That means if you are born on 1995, in the year 1995, before 1st September, okay, then you automatically become 25 years by 1st September and you are not applicable. But if you're born after 1995 September, that means your age is less than 25 years and you are eligible for applying. Okay, so this is the eligibility criteria explained for this position. Going down, so again there is an age relaxation that has been given. So for OBC non-creamy layer, there is 3 years of age relaxation. For scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, as you can see, there is a 5-year relaxation, and for people with disability, having 40% disability, there is a 10-year relaxation. Okay, so here there are more details about the same. You can read it. Educational qualifications, a full-time BE. Okay, they need people who have done full-time, not correspondence. Candidates must possess all your semester mark sheets and degree certificate in case of CGPA grading. Okay, the candidate applying for project engineer should possess the requisite number of years and hands-on post-qualification experience. So all this is what is required. So please read this in detail. Okay, mode of selection. So again, you can see here how your candidature, as in how your marks and everything will be considered. So 75% of importance will be given to your engineering score. Okay, so 10% will be given to your work experience. So in this case, there is no work experience, so this doesn't arise. Okay, your interview will determine 15%. Okay, your 15% will be determined for interview. So again, here they have explained how your application will be evaluated. You can read this in detail. So this is the allowances that has been given. Okay, and this is the application fee. So going down, for the trainee engineer position, that is the one that we are interested in, the application fee is rupees 200. So you have to make sure that you have a 200 rupee challan, DD or anything prepared so that you can enter it in the application form later. Okay. Application fee is non-refundable. The candidates may go through, you know, all this is regarding application. So how to apply? So how to apply? So here they have given the link. Okay. So here they have given the link, that is bellindia.in. So when you click on this link, you are redirected to this page. As you can see here, bellindia.in. Again, we are interested in the career section here. So click on here. So once you click on here, Bell Careers appears. This is a disclaimer that comes saying that there are a lot of people who are offering money and all. So you can read this in detail. Okay. And just say you confirm and you understand what is written in this dialog box and say submit. Okay. So as you can see, the page has opened. So here there are a lot of, there are five requirements that have been listed. So we are interested only in this requirement, that is the post and of for the software division. As you can see, I showed you the circular issued by the software division. So I will click here. So once I click here, click here to apply for the post. Okay, there are again lot of things, lot of documents that have to be submitted. So please make sure that if you are applicable for this, click on this. Okay, so once you click on this, all right, so you can see the format of everything that appears. Okay, so make sure that you have these documents ready as soon as possible. So the deadline for this is 27th. All right, so it is mentioned right here. The deadline for this position is, see, the last date to submit online application is 27/9/2020. So make sure you have all the documents in place before this date. Okay, so that your application is successful. So so whichever category do you belong to, you just click on that, a PDF will load and you will see the format of the documents that have to be submitted. All right, so now I have clicked on the application link and this is what my screen shows. So if I have already applied before, like I said, it takes time to get documents. So you can already log in using your registration number that you will get once you complete your registration and your date of birth. Okay, so you can log in using that, but since I'm doing this for the first time, I will click on new registration. So as soon as I click on new registration, this form appears. All right, so what has been asked in this form, see carefully. So first you have been asked to select the post. Okay, like I said, remember the code SDTE. Okay, so SDTE starts for the our trainee position. So as you can see here, okay, as you can see here, this is the freshers position that is there. This is the post engineering code. Okay, so we are applying for that position. So we are applying for that position over here. Understood. So your name, so this is automatically set in block letters. So type your name, your middle name, your last name. Okay, post that, your gender, whether you are a male or a female, date of birth. Make sure that your date of birth, click here to get your age as on 1st September 2020. Okay, so as you can see, I have entered a date which shows that I am 23 years, 1 month and 20 days. Okay, so you make sure you enter your right date. Okay, don't enter wrong details, because wrong details might lead to disqualification or debarment from the position. So make sure you enter the right details. I am entering wrong details for the sake of this video and for the sake of my successful registration. Okay, so again, my email ID I have given, father's name I have given, nationality I have given, religion I have given. There are a lot of choices for religion. Religion I have given, category I have given. So there are these category options. Am I a person with disability? If I am, I have to say yes and I have to submit a PWD certificate. Else I say no. Marital status has been asked. Marital status I say single. So I am going to submit this. Okay, so they ask me to check. Please validate and check. So please validate and check whether everything you have done is correct or not. Yes, it is correct. So confirm and continue. As you can see, the second page has appeared. Okay, so in the second page, you have to enter your permanent address first. Okay. So I am address. I am entering my permanent address here. Okay. So you can also enter your own address. Make sure that it is valid. This is not true. Okay. So make sure you enter your real address. Okay. Enter the name of the city. Okay. So in my case, it is Bengaluru. Okay, so enter the pin code. So without space, yeah. So state is Karnataka. If your correspondence address, that means the address that you presently stay, is same as your permanent address. Okay, so you see here my registration number has been generated. Okay, here your registration number is being asked, right? So once your application is successful, you have to enter this registration. Alright, always remember, this is the registration number and the date of birth, which is the day when you were born, you have to enter. Okay, so in my case, correspondence and this address is same. So I will just click this box. Okay, so you can see the addresses have always been entered. So again, what has been asked is my class 10th, my class 12th and my qualification. So I am a BE engineer, so discipline, there is only one choice, that is computer science. Okay, so I have to name the board here, so CBSE. Okay, I qualified from CBSE, so I'll write CBSE here. If you are the state board, so you write there as Karnataka State Board. Okay, you should write it as Karnataka State Board. So mine is CBSE, so I'll write it CBSE. Similarly, first class, okay, you write the percentage that you secured, okay, and the year of passing. So year of passing, again, it is 2014. Okay, this is 2016. This is my 12th. Okay, so again, I'll enter my 12th details. Okay, so engineering, again, 12th I did through CBSE. Okay, again, the name of the board university. Engineering I did under VTU. Okay, so this was also first class. Am I a diploma candidate? No, I am not. Is this a percentage CGPA? So it is a percentage system. Okay. So again, my pass out year. So my pass out year is going to be 2020. Alright. So SEM1. So I am just putting values. So for the sake of this application, you make sure you put your real values. Okay. There is no, you can't cheat over here. Okay. So make sure again, your experience is asked. So this is not compulsory. So you can skip this column. Okay. So again, details of the relative. So do you have you appeared for any test? So okay, as you can see, this red mark indicates compulsory. So these are not compulsory questions. So have you appeared for a test in Bell? So no, I have not appeared previously. So this is the most crucial part. You have to enter your SBI receipt number as soon as your receipt is issued. You have to write the date of issuing. Okay, so whatever the date of issue may be, okay, make sure that the date corresponds on both the documents. Otherwise, again, it will be a problem. Your candidature will not get accepted. Okay, so make sure that you do these things very carefully. The amount paid, which is 200. Okay, so once you do this, click on submit and your application will be done. So thank you guys for watching this.